The genesis of canine. The domestication of dogs. Where did they come from? And who are their ancestors? As the times passes, wolf evolve into dog. How does the evolution occurs? 30,000 years ago, when gray wolf ditched their packs. Because of severe shortages, then gray wolves joined human. 15,000 years ago, human fed them with leftovers food. Eventually the wild side of the wolf has been tame. 12,000 years ago, the domestic dogs show up. As years passed, the technology had been further developed, selecting breeding is introduced. And nowadays, dog has become man best friend. There are more than 160 type of dog breeds that share the genetics of a wolf. Tree of canine. First Miassi, common ancestor of dog and bear, 40 million years ago. Second Cynodictes, grandfather of all dog family. Third Daphinus, first bear dog. Fourth Lycaon, wild African hunting dog. Fifth Timarctus, immediate ancestor of dog family as we know it. Sixth Borophagus, early North American hyena-like offshoot. Seventh Gray wolf, father of all dog family that developed under man's selective dog breeding. Origins. Miassi first canine. About 60 million years ago, a small weasel-looking animal called the Miassi lived in Asia. According to scientists, this animal was the ancestor of common day dogs and other caniforms. Fossils of miassids were found in deposits of the late Paleocene epoch, to the late Eocene epochs in North America and in the late Eocene epoch in Europe and Asia. It is believed that early miassids were arboreal, and able to reverse their hind feet, like squirrels do. While they look quite different than modern dogs, their pelvis had a similar form and structure than those of dogs. Wolves, Canis lupus. More recently, genetic, morphologic, and behavioral studies suggest that domestic dogs derived from Canis lupus, or gray wolves. These wolves lived in the Nearctic and Palearctic regions, which means that domestic dogs must have either been brought to the New World by Pleistocene humans that came from Asia, or that they were domesticated independently from gray wolves referring. The latter is likely to be true, as there is evidence for the domestication of dogs in both the Old and the New Worlds. The oldest dog fossils in the New World were found in Danger Cave within the state of Utah, and are estimated to be somewhere between 9,000 and 10,000 years ago. Conversely, the oldest dog's fossils in the Old World date back between 12,000 to 14,000 years ago and were found in Germany, Israel and Iraq. Scientists believe it is likely that Native American dogs derived from American wolves. This is further evidence that there were separate domestication processes in the New and Old Worlds. It is quite difficult to analyze the origins of modern domestic dogs in the New World, because Native American dogs likely interbred with dogs brought to the region by European colonists. It is believed that Native American dogs now represent only a small portion of the current population of dogs in the New World, and Old World dogs have almost completely replaced them. Research has been done by comparing sequences from dogs around the world, and the results showed that both New and Old World dogs originated from Eurasian wolf. Gray wolves and dogs. If all dogs come from Eurasian wolves, then how did they get to the New World if not by humans? It is believed that they crossed in waves, likely thousands at a time, from Asia and to North America over the Bering Strait. This was possible when lower sea levels created a land bridge, which connected to two continents at a time before the end of the last ice age about 12,000 years ago. Unfortunately, the details about the evolution of dogs is largely unknown. Scientists will never know exactly when or how wolves were domesticated, although they do believe. In 2021, a literature review of the current evidence infers that the dog was domesticated in Siberia 23,000 years ago by ancient North Siberians, then later dispersed eastwards into the Americas and westwards across Eurasia. Some characteristics that were present in all early dogs were that they were carnivorous mammals that bore live young, had erect ears and wedge-shaped muzzles. Domestication of the dog started in Siberia 23,000 years ago by ancient North Siberians, by people who hunted for plants and animals. The dogs were used to help the hunters find what they needed as well as guarding their land from any danger. However, what's interesting is that after all the benefits people received from the dogs, the animals were also used as food. As mentioned in the origins section, the exact origins of domestic dogs isn't certain. However, dog domestication helps explain the reasoning of human evolution, because they explain how the human population may have initiated or responded to increasingly domestic interactions with animals. A common opinion indicates that hunter-gatherers were very relevant in the beginning stages of dog domestication. The hunter-gatherers living in a remote camp would have overlapping ecological niches with the wolves living in surrounding wooded areas. The wolves and hunter-gatherers hunted for the same prey, and quickly began to learn to scavenge off of one another, to find the most success in their hunting for animals. The wolves would take the kills from man and vice versa. Through this unsolicited relationship, both the wolves and humans helped one another for each species' benefit. Humans also came in regular contact with the wolves, as they inhabited and walked through common areas and camps. With humans constantly being around, we can assume that wolves became more comfortable around the human species and vice versa. Both parties became so comfortable that some humans would take the wolves and cubs into their home as family pets. The idea of wolves becoming pets shows that some portion of the species population grew to be receptive of the idea of human interaction. Beneficial to both parties. Many people assume that domestication only benefits the humans and hurts the plants and animals being domesticated. That is not the case. Many humans domesticate for their own benefit, but there is also animal-animal and animal-plant domestication, like symbiosis. In these scenarios, animals benefit just as much as the counterpart, animals, plants, and humans. Carrying on the corn example, the corn plant is reliant on humans to achieve reproductive success. Turning to our main topic, the domestication of the dog decreased the wolf species population, but vastly increased the dog population. There are millions of dogs today, inhabiting every part of the world. Therefore, domestication was seen as the symbolic relationship between two organisms, with evolutionary benefits to both. Many animals or species slowly begin to change characteristics and specific roles as they are integrated into human life. They become objects of ownership, inheritance, exchange, trade, etc. Humans carefully domesticates the animals to obtain economic stability and benefit to the community. Humans obtain this benefit by mastering the animals, breeding, placing the animals in the territory where they will most likely meet their goals or ideas, and provide the animals with a proper diet. These three factors, breeding, territory, and food supply, are the main aspects of the experiment that humans can control to achieve success in their domestication. Artificial selection differs from natural selection, as humans play the vital role in the selection instead of nature. Humans inflict change on the plants and animals, and the change does not appear naturally. As mentioned before, through the artificial selection, man isolated the animal and places them in precise breeding and territorial areas, along with keeping a close eye on each animal's food supply. Through this process, the man hopes that the animals will form desirable traits and reproduce the traits to their offspring and so on. One can assume that through artificial selection and domestication, people can be considered an integral part of nature. Evidence of rapid evolution shows that the transition from wolves to dogs happened quickly. Human and wolf interactions with each other, starting in the Ice Age, could have domesticated wolves, which then lead to changes in appearance through inbreeding to dog-wolf. The dog-wolf population started to breed with each other, or inbreed. This process is when a genetic mutation can occur and then passed on and eventually become a popular characteristic within the population. Inbreeding can be controlled to allow certain characteristics to become more popular faster. By scartation and selection, therefore, this is a decision which traits wants to be passed on to create a new species. Coppingers process and steps for the domestication of dogs. First, people create new village niches. Some wolves enter new niches to obtain food. Second, those wolves are more tolerant of human presence. Third, such wolves are a selective advantage over the wildest wolves. Fourth, this is an adaptation of their sketch. The wolf species began to undergo morphological changes, as they began to feel accustomed around human beings. The many physical changes, through time, transformed the wolf into a dog, showcasing the dog characteristics we see today. Traditionally, what archaeologists have found, and used to designate an animal as a dog, versus a wolf, is an overall reduction in size, a shortening of the jaw, crowding of the teeth, and other features, that would indicate that it was a small kind of wolf. The wolf practically morphed into a smaller dog-like form, with an overall tamer agenda. Mutations can have a large effect on a species, and only a few mutations can transform a species with favored physical and genetic changes. Researchers have found a gene that regulates smallness within dogs, indicating why they appear to be smaller than their wolf ancestors. The gene for size is interesting, as today, many people characterize dogs with their size being small, medium, large. Size is one of the main characteristics that help humans categorize all the different dog breeds. Shepherd dog had been part of us for thousands of years. Hunting dogs played main role as part of hunting sport. Dog were used for transportation in Arctic, and they accompany handicapped people. Farm fox experiment. Russian biologist Dmitry Kabayev performed a similar experiment to replicate the domestication of dogs. During this experiment, Bayev took 130 silver foxes and, at a month old, placed the foxes in cages and fed them with certain foods while stroking the fox pups. He repeated the process of territorial placement, dietary restrictions, and stroking until the foxes reached a mature age. Once they hit maturity, each fox received a tameness score, where some appeared to be less fearful of humans than others. Bayev believed that a similar situation happened with the domestication of dogs. Natural selection favored the wolves that did not respond aggressively to humans. Similarly, Bayev took the tamed foxes and let them reproduce with one another. He found that over time, the tameness score increased among the foxes, signaling behavior influenced by genes and parent offspring. Genomes. Where or how many times dogs have domesticated is tricky to specifically answer, because there's multiple cases where DNA sequences have been found in more than one place. From some research, DNA sequences from 59 European dogs from up to 14,000 years old was discovered in Ireland, along with a genome of a dog of 4,800 years old. However, looking at these genomes compared to other dog breeds and wolves shows that dogs were domesticated from Asia around 14,000 years ago, which suggests that their lineages could have separated to East Asia and Western Eurasia between 14,000 to 6,400 years ago. There was a study done that compared whole genomes of two dogs from Germany, from the early and then Neolithic, one 7,000 years old, and the other 4,700 years old. As a result, there was genetic continuity of ancient and modern European dogs sharing ancestry, meaning modern dogs evolved from the Neolithic population. Therefore, the older specimen that was 7,000 years old was found in the early Neolithic period, and the younger specimen, 4,700 years old, relates to the end Neolithic period. After looking at the whole genome sequences for each dog, high endogenous canine DNA is established for both. As humans discovered the desirable traits of dogs, such as increased speed, strength, sight, and smell compared to humans, they decided to select the ones which best exhibited these qualities for breeding. In the Middle East, dogs which were fleet-footed side hounds were the most appreciated by noblemen. In Europe, however, bigger and stronger dogs like mastiffs were preferred in order to protect homes and their owners from harm. With the rise of agriculture, newer dog breeds were developed, such as herding dogs, charged with guarding livestock. In England, terriers were developed for the purpose of rat extermination in barns and granaries. In terms of hunting, pointing and retrieving breeds were chosen to help find and capture game animals. Some breeds of dogs are ancient, while others are quite recent. While dogs were similar, there is fossil evidence from the Bronze Age that suggested that five different types of dogs existed at that time. These distinct dog categories were mastiffs, wolf-type dogs, sighthounds like greyhounds, pointing dogs, and herding dog archaic shepherd. Researchers claim that the dog's wolf ancestors likely originated in multiple locations, as one of their closest relatives, the gray wolf, was able to mobilize in both the New and Old World. However, I believe the species of Canis lupus familiaris was born and originated in Asia, for three serious reasons. 1. Evidence of gatherers and livestock start in Asia as nomadic pastoralism. 2. In Asia still have ancient breeds from ancient civilizations, like nomadic archaic shepherd, the mastiff branch of Assyrian mastiff nowadays, bully kuda, saluki and ancient dog of East Asia. Third, by judge the anatomy of the skull of archaic primitive shepherd in Central Asia, as morphometric analyzes, which is most closest skull with first proto-wolf dogs. The process of domestication itself, has based off of evidence, happened multiple times, in various locations around the world. Yet, strong evidence reveals, that hunter-gatherer in Siberia, domesticated wolves to become vital hunting partners. With their everyday interactions with the species, the wolves began to experience morphological changes that allowed them to slowly evolve into a dog-like species. Through artificial selection from humans, dogs have become what we know them to be in the present, man's best friend. Traits which have been beneficial to humans have been reproduced, and there are now numerous breeds that serve different purposes. It can be quite interesting to reflect on the fact that modern dogs have been created for the purpose of humans. Quite literally, their being reflects the needs that people have had throughout time. Thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share.